and good evening to you wherever you are in the world. I hope you're all staying well, staying safe and staying in the Lord. And I'm trusting and hoping that this video meets you well. This video, which I am also excited to make for your viewing and learning pleasure. Anyways, welcome back to my channel. My name is Oluwakemi Osege as usual. And just again, before I start, I want to appreciate you all for being here, for subscribing to my channel, for liking my videos, and for commenting on my video. And please do share them. Thank you so much. Actually, it is Friday. Today is Friday, the 6th of November, 2020. And I am about to create a cake. So I thought, since I don't have the video of that cake already on my YouTube video, it would be a great idea for me to record the baking of that cake recipe. And to assist me today, as usual, I always have my daughter around, and she's going to be doing whatever she can to assist me today. And I introduce her to you. And her name, she's even taller than I am now. She's bigger than me. Can you imagine? Oh my goodness. She's only 12, you see. Look at how big she is. Anyway, this is my daughter. I'm sure you've seen her in my earlier videos. And what's your name?
My name is Kelly. Huh? Hello, everyone.
Well, I had to force her to come on the video tonight. Anyways, she's going to be assisting me, whether she's on the video or she's in the background. We are going to be doing all this together, or she's going to be watching what I do in any event. Anyways, today I am making cookies and cream cake. I know there's quite a bit of recipes out there on the web, however this is the one I have seen and developed myself, and I've, because of all the feedbacks I get from them, I've stuck to it. People come back with excellent feedbacks on this recipe, and that's the one I'm going to show you how I do today. It is how I bake my cookies and cream cake. So a lot of people call it Oreo cookies flavor. It is cookies and cream cake, it is Oreo cookies, whatever you choose to call it. This is the way I bake mine. If you have a recipe that works for you, great. However, this is how I bake mine, so, and that's what I'm going to show you how I do today. Anyways, I am going to now show you my ingredients. That's my ingredients laid out. In here, I've got 830 grams of self-raising flour. I have got 760 grams in here of caster sugar, or baking sugar. In here I have got 420 grams of crushed Oreos, that's crushed Oreo cookies. In here I have got 620 grams of butter, room temperature butter. In here I have got 11 medium-sized eggs. I have got in here 395 mils of buttermilk, and I have got in here 465 mils of whole milk. In here I have got half a teaspoon, a quarter of a teaspoon, and it's 0.8 teaspoon of baking soda. And the same measurement I've got here of salt as half a teaspoon, a quarter of a teaspoon, and 0.8 teaspoonful of salt. And of course I have got my measuring spoons, and I will be using stand mixers today. Let us move on to the mixing and baking process. And thought I should say as well, prior to starting, I had already preheated my oven to gas mark 3, and that's an equivalent of 160 degrees centigrade. As I stated in my earlier video, that I love to bake longer at a lower temperature. This recipe that I have today is, I'm making it for an 8-inch sized cake, which is for delivery tomorrow or for pickup tomorrow. So usually if I was going to do, if you wanted to do a smaller version, if you require that, I'm happy to drop a recipe for that in the comment section if you want that. However, this one, this measurement I have is for an 8-inch run of at least 6 inches high cake. So to start with, I'm now going to, that's my salt, pour it into my flour, my dry ingredients, and then that's my baking powder again, pour into my flour, and then whisk together, That's my dry ingredients, that's, which is a mixture of my self-raising flour and my salt and my baking soda. That is my bicarbonate of soda. You will notice that I'm not using baking powder. I didn't add baking powder in this. That is because my flour is self-raising, which means it already has baking powder contained in it. So I don't need to add additional baking powder. If I was using plain flour, then I would need to add the baking powder. But in this instance, because I'm using self-raising, I do not need to add the baking powder. As you can see from the video, I am sieving my flour. I tend to do that a lot with my cakes. That is, this helps to incorporate air into the cake and improve the overall texture and overall outcome of the cake when it is baked. And also, sieving your flour helps you to get rid of any unwanted particles that might have accidentally fallen into your flour. You know, I don't have that problem because my flour is always stored airtight. However, I still love to have air properly incorporated. So I sieve my flour 3 times before I use it. The third and final sieve. And that's my dried ingredients prepared. So set that aside. Now my eggs. And let me tell you, it's been most of my cake recipe, I do not use my eggs whole. As you would have heard in some of my videos, I do not use my eggs whole. I tend to separate my egg whites from my egg yolks and add them at different stages of the mixing process. In the case of this cookies and cream recipe, most of the time I use my eggs whole. But on this occasion, I'm going to separate my egg whites from my egg yolks. I only do that for my cookies and cream. I can use it either way, use the full cream, or I mean full egg, or use the separated eggs. So now I'm not going to be separating my egg whites from my egg yolks. Another thing I tend to do with my eggs is to remove, with my egg whites, to remove the crumbs or some things that I don't find acceptable in the eggs. If you break eggs, you see that you agree with me that there's some white crumbs that is always inside. I don't know whether they're the embryos, but whatever they are called, I don't like them, so I get rid of them. I take great care and attention in the creation of my cakes, either baking or decorating. So. That's my eggs and flour and dry ingredients prepared. So we are now going to proceed to the mixing or creaming of the caster sugar and the butter. That's my butter now going into the stand mixer. I'm using the paddle attachment, as you can see. And you can see my butter at the moment is yellow. And then my baking sugar. And beat or cream until the butter is soft, creamy and fluffy, or it's pale white. It's pale white, no longer yellow. It could take up to 10 minutes and you're mixing it at a speed level between of medium to high speed, depending on the power of your mixer. And don't forget, as you mix, it is important that you spread down your bowl to ensure that all aspects of your mixture is captured and mixed. My butter and sugar have been creaming for about 7 minutes now. I'm scraping down my bowl to ensure that all aspects of the mixture is captured. It's still a bit yellowish, but we're getting there. I'm going to whisk it for another 3 minutes and then I will be adding my vanilla extract. My mixture has been going up for about 3 minutes now. I'm now going to be adding my 3.5 teaspoonful of vanilla extract. I just recall that I didn't mention when I was listing out the ingredients. So it is 3.5 teaspoonful of vanilla extract I will be adding now. I will now be adding my egg yolks, one yolk at a time. And mix until properly incorporated. My mixture is ready, so I will now be adding my milk. That's a combination of buttermilk and whole milk, alternating it with my dry ingredient. That's a combination of my self-raising flour, my salt, and my baking soda. And whilst I'm doing that, on another stand mixer, I will be whisking my egg whites to thick or soft mid-speed consistency. Now adding my flour, a portion of my flour. At this stage, my mixing speed is reduced, so that I don't overmix my flour. Now that I'm adding my flour, I will be alternating my flour with my liquid ingredient, that's my milk, and we reduce my speed, and also to avoid splatter all over the plate. It's flour and water or liquid, so you don't want to finish mixing and then start thinning, doing deep thinning. As you can see, I'm just steadying up my mix. Pour a portion of my milk. And then steady. My kind of mixture is not one that can mix very slow, no. So that's why I'm doing stop and start. So if even the lowest speed is high. So that's why. At this stage, I'm going to scrape down my bowl. And then pour the remainder of my flour. Try as much as possible not to overmix or overbeat your mixture now that your flour is added. And then whisk for the last time. My batter is ready. So is my egg white properly whisked to stick consistency. As you can see, I used the whisk attachment for my whisking of my egg whites. Different attachments for different purposes. My batter is ready. So what I'm now going to do now is to fold in the egg whites. I've got my tins, they're already lined, my 8-inch tins. I'm going to fold it in, not to mix. And this is my 420 grams of crushed Oreo cookies. I'm going to show you a trick I do. In order to prevent my Oreo cookies from sinking down the cake. A trick I learned that in order to prevent that, you add some flour, you mix your Oreo cookies with flour so that they don't just all gather in one section of your cake. You put flour in there, I think it's supposed to make it lightweight and sit up. They just add a little bit of flour and mix it together with your Oreo, and your Oreo cookie stays as it's supposed to be. I need to wash my hands. Now, my mixture. Now, fold in my drying my egg whites. In fact, this measurement of ingredients of batter could actually bake in a 10-inch round tin or square, and you have sufficient. But I usually love my cakes to be tall, so I rather have more than to have less. So I'm folding in, and then adding some of my Oreo cookies. Again, folding in. And I preheated my oven to desktop number 3. This cake, I expect it to bake for up to 2 hours because I'm baking at a lower temperature. Making the cake tins as equal as possible. Over time, I have learned to be able to correctly gauge my batter in my tin. I don't measure anymore. At the start, I used to measure each batter into the tin, but this over time, I learned not to measure anymore. So I just gauge it, and most of the time, it's always correct. So I'm gonna tap. This is to get rid of excess bubbles in your batter, so that you don't cut through the cake and then there's a big hole in some parts. That's excess bubbles. This helps to prevent that, this tapping. Gentle tapping. So I'm now going to put my cakes in the oven. That's my 160 degrees centigrade. And it's gonna bake for at least 2 hours. Because this is a bigger portion of batter. And baking at a lower temperature. Until when a skewer inserted in the center of the cake comes out clean, then that's when you know that your cake is baked. Hello, welcome back. My cake is fully baked now. I'm not sure if you can see them behind me. Three perfectly baked round cakes in here. I've got three cakes. They're still cooling, they're still hot. So you can see they bake for about 2 hours. They're about 3 inches each. So I won't have a problem with getting at least a 6-inch tall cake, at least. But I'm hoping to get 7. Definitely I'm gonna get 7 from this height after torting and feeling. Anyways, that's the end of the video. I'm gonna show you a picture of the cake when I cut it or tort it to decorate tomorrow. It's still cool enough because it's still very warm, so I cannot cut it now and begin to decorate. It's too warm to do that. However, I promise that a picture of the inside of the cake will be done. I'll take a picture of it and post and share after this video, and also a picture of the finished decorated cake also will be posted after the video. Thank you for watching, and this is, you can see how beautiful it looks, how beautifully baked it is. Thank you for watching, and we hope you continue to stay safe and stay well. And please do not forget to like, share, comment. I love to read your thoughts. If you think there's something I've done greatly, please do leave your thoughts in the comment section. And if you think there's something I have done that I could have done differently, again, I will appreciate your constructive criticism. Please do drop your thoughts in the comment section, and I will really greatly appreciate them. And do not forget to like, to to share and comment and also subscribe, and do not forget to hit that notification bell. This will alert you anytime I upload a new video. Thank you so much, and please, if you think there's anything, any video you would want me to do or recipe, please do give me a bell or comment in the comment section and I'll consider it. I'm trying to get into the swing of creating videos probably weekly, depending on my time availability, but I will try to continue to do that. Thank you, and please continue to stay safe, continue to abide by the safety rules. Thank you for watching and God bless you.
The inside of my cookies and cream cake, that's the my cookies and cream cakes, all toasted, filled with buttercream and stacked.